Hello my dear students, hope you all are fine and safe at your home. In the previous classes we discussed about the limits of trigonometric functions. In that we discussed about the cases when our limit x tends to 0 only, because we know only one result, that is limit theta tends to 0 sin theta by theta is equal to 1. So we can use this formula when our value theta tends to 0 only. Now what will happen when our angle does not tend to 0? Some questions will be there in which our angle does not tend to 0. Then how we will do the question? So just write down the rule for that. Suppose our value of x tends to any other variable there. Suppose when x tends to a, then how we will do the question related to trigonometric ratio? In that case, what we will do? We will substitute. Just write down the step there. We will substitute x is equal to a plus h. So whatever angle is there, we will write down that angle here. X is equal to a plus h. Now here how the limit will change, that we can check. When x tends to a, its meaning is when the value of x is approximately equal to a, what will be the value of h? Yes, when we will take x is equal to a, we will get here a is equal to a plus h, which will give you h is equal to 0. So when we can say when x tends to a, then our limit h tends to 0. And after that we will continue with the following steps there. So shall we start? Okay, write down. The first question is, evaluate the following limits. In that, first one is limit x tends to pi by 2 1 plus cos 2x by pi minus 2x the whole square. Now just check here our value of x tends to pi by 2. So what we will take x is equal to? Yes, we will take x is equal to pi by 2 plus h. After that what we will write? Just write down there as x tends to pi by 2. Meaning when the value of x will be equal to pi by 2, then what will be the value of h? Yes, value of h will be equal to 0. So we will write down there h tends to 0. Now in the given question, in place of x everything, we are going to substitute pi by 2 plus h. So our value will become in this way now. Limit, in place of x tends to pi by 2, what we will write? H tends to 0. H tends to 0. 1 plus cos 2. In place of x, where x is there, we will substitute pi by 2 plus h. Then we will get 2 into pi by 2 plus h by pi minus 2 into pi by 2 plus h the whole square. Now first we can simplify it. We will get limit h tends to 0 1 plus this 2 will get multiplied inside. Then we will get here cos 2 into pi by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled here. We will get pi plus 2 into h will be equal to 2h by here pi minus 2 into pi by 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled here. We will get here minus pi minus 2h the whole square. Now here again we have to use the concept of trigonometry there. The basic concept which we studied in trigonometric function. So just check here. Limit h tends to 0, 1 plus cos pi plus something there. So cos pi plus something. As we know here, this is 0 degree, this is pi by 2, this one is pi, this one is 3 pi by 2, and again we are having here 2 pi. So when it is written cos pi plus something, means we are in which quadrant? Yes, we are in third quadrant. And in third quadrant, cos is positive or negative? Yes, cos is negative. So it can be written as 1 minus cos 2h by, here pi and pi will get cancelled, will get there minus 2h the whole square, which is equal to 4h square. Now to use the concept of trigonometry, it should be converted in terms of sine there. Now, cos 2h, which formula of cos theta we will use? Yes, cos 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sine square theta. So that formula we are going to use here, then we will get 1 minus, inside the bracket, 1 minus 2 sine square h by 4h square. So when we will open the bracket, 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled and minus into minus will become positive there. Then we will get there 2 sine square h. Sine square h can be written as sine h into sine h by 4. H square, how we can rewrite there? H into h. So just rearrange that so that we can use the formula there. Now just to check, limit h tends to 0, sine h by h will be equal to 1. Similarly, limit h tends to 0, this sine h by h also is equal to 1. 2 and 4 we can cancel here. Then what will be our answer? Yes, our answer will be equal to 1 by 2. So I hope this method is clear. Okay, now we'll do the next question. Write down there. Question number 2. In question number 2, it is written limit x tends to pi by 4 sine x minus cos x by x minus pi by 4. Limit x tends to pi by 4 sine x minus cos x by x minus pi by 4. Again, what we will substitute in place of x? X tends to which number? Pi by 4. So we will write down there x is equal to pi by 4 plus h. So as x tends to pi by 4, h will tends to, yes, h will tends to 0. Now just to substitute there, where you have x, in place of x substitute pi by 4 plus h. Then we will get limit h tends to 0 sine, in place of x we are going to write now pi by 4 plus h, minus cos, again in place of x we will write down there pi by 4 plus h, whole divided by pi by 4 plus h minus pi by 4. So here pi by 4 and minus pi by 4 will get cancelled. Now here we can use the formula sine a plus b. Can you tell me what is sine a plus b? Yes, sine a into cos b plus cos a into sin b. Then you will get here sin pi by 4 into cos h plus cos pi by 4 into sin h minus. In the same way, here also we will use the formula cos a plus b. What is cos a plus b? Yes, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Then we will get cos pi by 4 into cos h minus sin pi by 4 into sin h, whole divided by h. Now in place of sin pi by 4 cos pi by 4 we can substitute the value. Then we will get limit h tends to 0. What is the value of sin pi by 4? 1 by root 2. Then we will get here 1 by root 2 cos h plus 1 by root 2 sin h. Negative sign will get multiplied inside. Then we will get here minus 1 by root 2 cos h. Minus into minus will become plus there. Then we will get here plus 1 by root 2 sin h whole divided by h. Now anything will get cancelled here? Yes, 1 by root 2 cos h minus 1 by root 2 cos h got cancelled. Now what is remaining there? Limit h tends to 0, 1 by root 2 sin h plus 1 by root 2 sin h. That will be equal to, yes, 2 by root 2 sin h by h. Again, limit h tends to 0, sin h by h is equal to 1. And 2 by root 2, how we can cancel? This 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. So 1 root 2 will get cancelled, remaining answer will be equal to root 2. Okay. Now we can check the next question. Write down. Next question is question number 3. Limit x tends to pi by 2, 1 minus sin x by pi by 2 minus x the whole square. Now what we will substitute? Yes, we will substitute x is equal to pi by 2 plus h. If you want, you can substitute pi by 2 minus h also, because this concept what we are using, that is right hand limit there. When we started the concept of limits, I told you what is left hand limit and right hand limit. So that only we are calculating here. Okay. Plus sign we have taken so that our calculation will be easy there. So now here we are going to change the limits also. So it will be equal to limit h tends to 0, 1 minus sine into, in place of x it will be equal to pi by 2 plus h, by denominator pi by 2 minus x, in place of x we are substituting pi by 2 plus h. Whenever negative sign is there you should put the bracket. Okay, so now we will get here limit x tends to 0, 1 minus, now just to check what is written, sin pi by 2 plus h, sin pi by 2 plus theta, which quadrant? Yes, sin 90 plus theta means it is in second quadrant, and in second quadrant sin is positive, but since it is 90 degree sin will change to cos. Yes, so sin pi by 2 plus h can be written as cos h. By here when we will open the bracket, what will come? Pi by 2 minus pi by 2 minus h the whole square. So pi by 2 and minus pi by 2 will get cancelled here. Now remaining we are getting 1 minus cos h. Again, how we can get their sin? Yes, we know cos 2 theta is 1 minus 2 sin square theta. In the same way cos h can be written as 1 minus 2 sin square h by 2. By denominator we have minus h the whole square will be equal to plus h square. Now we will open the bracket there, then 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled, we will get here 2 sin square h by 2, so that can be written as sin h by 2 into sin h by 2 by h square. How we can rewrite that? X square can be written as h into h, but since here the angle is h by 2, here also we should have h by 2, but at present we don't have h by 2 here, then what we should do? Yes, we'll multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. Here also h by 2 into 2. Now this expression will be equal to 1. This one also will become equal to 1. Now what is remaining there? 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Remaining is equal to 1 by 2. So the answer will be equal to 1 by 2. So I hope this question is clear. Okay. Now we can check the next question. X tends to pi by 6, 2 minus root 3 cos x, 2 minus root 3 cos x minus sin x by 6x minus pi d whole square. 2 minus root 3 cos x minus sin x by 6x minus pi d whole square. Again we will substitute x is equal to pi by 6 plus h. So our question will become now limit h tends to 0, 2 minus root 3 into cos pi by 6 plus h minus sin pi by 6 plus h. By denominator 6 into pi by 6 plus h minus pi d whole square. Limit h tends to 0, 2 minus root 3 into, now first we will use the formula cos a plus b. Cos a plus b is cos A cos B. So cos pi by 6 into cos H minus sin A sin B. Sin pi by 6 into sin H. Then here minus, minus sign is there, that's why I'm putting the bracket here. We'll use the formula here, sin A plus B. What is sin A plus B? Sin A into cos B. Then we will get here sin pi by 6 into cos H plus cos A into sin B. Cos pi by 6 into sin H by denominator will be equal to 6 will get multiplied here. Then we will get 6 into pi by 6 pi plus 6 into H will be equal to 6H minus pi the whole square. Then pi and minus pi will get cancelled here. Now we can check how to simplify it. Limit H tends to 0, 2 minus root 3 into cos pi by 6. Cos pi by 6 means that is cos 30 degree. And what is cos 30 degree? Root 3 by 2. So we are getting here root 3 by 2 cos H minus sin pi by 6. Pi by 6 sin 30 degree. So here we will get here 1 by 2 sin H minus sin pi by 6. So that is 1 by 2. So we will get here 1 by 2 cos H plus root 3 by 2 sin H whole divided by denominator 36H square equal to limit H tends to 0 2 minus root 3. Now we get multiplied inside. Then root 3 into root 3 will be equal to 3. Then we will get here 3 by 2 cos H minus into minus will be equal to plus. So plus root 3 by 2 sin H minus 1 by 2 cos H minus root 3 by 2 sin H whole divided by 36 H square. Now anything will get cancelled here? Yes, plus root 3 by 2 H minus root 3 by 2 H got cancelled. Now what is remaining here? Limit H tends to 0, 2 minus 3 by 2 cos H minus 1 by 2 cos H. What will come? Minus 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2 will be equal to minus 4 by 2. And minus 4 by 2 is minus 2. So we'll get there minus 2 cos H by denominator we have 36 H square. So again what we can take common? Yes, we can take 2 common from here. So taking 2 outside, then we will get limit H tends to 0, 2 into inside the bracket what will come? 1 minus cos H by 36 H square. Again that cos should be converted in terms of sin there. So how we can rewrite? Shall I write directly? Because we know cos H, what we will substitute for cos H? 1 minus 2 sin square H by 2. So 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled. Minus into minus will be equal to plus. So we'll get there 2 sin square H by 2, which can be written as 2 sin H by 2 into sin H by 2 by 36 H square. 36 we can rewrite here. H square can be written as H into H. But to use the formula, what we need here? H by 2. So here written H by 2 and here also written H by 2. So if we have divided, we have to multiply also. Now this value is equal to 1. Again this one also is equal to 1. Now any other thing will get cancelled? Yes, here 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Here also 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So we are getting the answer is equal to 1 by 36. Clear? Okay. Now we can check the next question. Next question is limit x tends to pi by 6. Limit x tends to pi by 6 root 3 sin x minus cos x by x minus pi by 6. So again, what we will substitute? X is equal to pi by 6 plus h. So our question will become now limit h tends to 0 root 3 into sine pi by 6 plus h minus cos pi by 6 plus h whole divided by, in place of x we are substituting pi by 6 plus h minus pi by 6. So pi by 6 and minus pi by 6 got cancelled here. Now remaining is limit h tends to 0 root 3 into, now going to use the formula sin a plus b. Sin a plus b is sin a into cos b. So sin pi by 6 into cos h plus cos pi by 6 into sin h minus cos a plus b can be written as cos a cos b. So cos pi by 6 into cos h minus sin a sin b sin pi by 6 into sin h whole divided by h. Okay. So now next step is limit h tends to 0 root 3 will get multiplied inside. Okay, what is the value of sin pi by 6? Pi by 6 means that is 30 degree. Sin 30 degree is 1 by 2. So root 3 multiplied by 1 by 2. So we will get there root 3 by 2 into cos h. Cos pi by 6 root 3 by 2. So root 3 into root 3 will be equal to 3. So 3 by 2 into sin h minus, here minus will get multiplied inside, cos pi by 6 is root 3. So minus root 3 by 2 cos h minus into minus will be equal to plus. Plus 1 by 2 into sin h whole divided by h. Anything will get cancelled? Yes. Root 3 by 2 cos h minus root 3 by 2 cos h got cancelled. 3 by 2 sin h plus 1 by 2 sin h. What will be that one? 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 will be equal to 4 by 2. And 4 by 2 is 2. So we are getting here 2 sin h by h. So again limit h tends to 0 sin theta by theta. Sin h by h is equal to 1. So our answer will be equal to 2. Okay. Now next question. Next one is evaluate limit x tends to a sin x minus sin a by x minus a. Limit x tends to a sin x minus sin a by x minus a. So first what we can do? Yes, we can substitute x is equal to a plus h. So our limit changes to now limit h tends to 0. In place of x we are going to substitute a plus h. So sin a plus h minus sin a by, in place of x, a plus h minus a. So a and a will get cancelled here. Now remaining limit h tends to 0. Now just to check here, our expression is written in the form of sin c minus sin d, correct? Sin c minus sin d. Can you tell me what is sin c minus sin d? Yes, 2 cos, correct? 2 cos c plus d by 2. In place of c what we have? A plus h plus a by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. So sin a plus h minus a by 2 whole divided by h. Okay. Now next step, limit h tends to 0 2 cos, what is remaining coming here? 2 cos a plus a will be equal to 2a plus h by 2 into sin a and minus a will get cancelled, we will get there sin h by 2. Now just to check here, in denominator we have h there, so that h we can write here, so that we can use the formula. But to use the formula what we need here? H by 2. Here we don't have h by 2. So again multiplied the numerator and denominator by 2. So this expression now it will be equal to 1. Here 2 and 2 will get cancelled here. Now in place of h we can substitute 0. Then what will come? When we will substitute 0, then we will get here cos 2a by 2. So 2 and 2 also will get cancelled. We will get the answer is equal to cos a. Okay. Now the next one. Next question is limit x tends to pi by 2. Limit x tends to pi by 2 cos x by pi by 2 minus x. What we will substitute here? X is equal to pi by 2 plus h. So now the question, now just to check how it will become. Limit h tends to 0 cos pi by 2 plus h by pi by 2 minus, since minus sign is there, that minus when we will substitute here will get multiplied by both the terms. Then we will get here minus pi by 2 minus h. So pi by 2 and minus pi by 2 got cancelled here. So next step now, limit h tends to 0 cos 90 plus theta. Cos 90 plus theta will be in which quadrant? Yes, it is in second quadrant, and in second quadrant cos is negative, and in 90 degree cos will change to sine. Then we will get here minus sine h by minus h. So minus and minus will get cancelled. Limit h tends to 0 sine h by h is equal to 1. So our answer will be equal to 1. Okay. Now the next one we can do. Next question is limit x tends to pi by 3. Limit x tends to pi by 3 root 3 minus tan x by pi minus 3x. Root 3 minus tan x by pi minus 3x. So here we are going to substitute now. X is equal to pi by 3 plus h. So it will become now limit h tends to 0 root 3 minus tan pi by 3 plus h by pi minus 3 into pi by 3 plus h equal to limit h tends to 0 root 3 minus tan pi by 3 plus h. So we are going to use the formula tan a plus b. What is tan a plus b? Yes, tan a plus tan b. So we will get there tan pi by 3. What is tan pi by 3? Root 3 plus tan b. So that is tan h by 1 minus tan pi by 3 into tan h. So we will get there 1 minus root 3 tan h whole divided by pi minus 3 into pi by 3. Pi and pi will get cancelled. We will get there minus pi and minus 3h. So here pi and minus pi will get cancelled. Now here we can do the cross multiplication, and it will come now limit h tends to 0 root 3 can be written as root 3 by 1. So when you will do the cross multiplication, it will be equal to 1 minus root 3 into root 3, 3. 1 minus 3 tan h. Minus sign will get multiplied inside, not 1, here root 3 will come. Root 3 minus 3 tan h minus root 3 minus into plus. So that will be negative, so we will get there minus tan h. Minus tan h by here 1 minus root 3 tan h is remaining, and when we will change the division into multiplication, it will come in denominator. So we can write down that minus 3 h here in denominator. Now anything will get cancelled here? Yes, root 3 and minus root 3 will get cancelled here. So remaining it will be equal to limit h tends to 0 minus 3 tan h minus h will be equal to minus 4 tan h by 1 minus root 3 tan h into minus 3 h. So here minus and minus will get cancelled. Now we can check how we can use the formula. We know, what we know, limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta is equal to 1. Now what will happen if in place of sin theta we have tan theta? What will be the value of tan theta by theta? We know tan theta can be written as sin theta by cos theta. So limit theta tends to 0, in place of tan theta we are writing sin theta by cos theta. This theta will come here only. Now limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta is equal to 1. Now we'll substitute cos theta is equal to 0, then cos 0 also is equal to 1. So this one also we can use as a formula there. Limit theta tends to 0, tan theta by theta is equal to 1. So here we have limit h tends to 0, tan h by h, till here. Tan h by h, that is equal to 1. Now here just to substitute h is equal to 0, then what will come? Root 3 into 0 will become 0. So remaining we are getting here 4 by 3. Okay. Now the next one is evaluate limit x tends to pi by 4 1 minus sin 2x by 1 plus cos 4x. So what we will substitute in place of x? In place of x we are going to substitute pi by 4 plus h. So our question will become now limit h tends to 0, 1 minus sin 2 into pi by 4 plus h by denominator 1 plus cos 4 into pi by 4 plus h. Now we can simplify it, then we will get limit h tends to 0, 2 will get multiplied inside, then we will get here 1 minus sin 2 into pi by 4. So 2 and 4 will get cancelled, we get there pi by 2 plus 2h by denominator 1 plus cos 4 into pi by 4. So that will be equal to pi plus 4h equal to limit h tends to 0, 1 minus sin pi by 2 plus something. Sin pi by 2 plus theta. In which quadrant pi by 2 plus theta? This is pi by 2. Plus something means we are coming in second quadrant. And in second quadrant we know sin is? Yes, sin is positive there. And in 90 degree, whenever odd multiple of pi by 2 is there, sin will change to cos there. Then we will get there 1 minus cos 2h by. Now our denominator 1 plus cos pi plus something. Pi means here we have 180 degree. Pi plus something means where we are going? We are going in third quadrant. And in third quadrant cos is negative. So it will be equal to. And in even multiple of pi by 2, it will not change there. So we will get there 1 minus cos 4h. Now we can use the formula to change cos in terms of sin. 1 minus cos 2h. Now since we are using the formula so many times, now we can write the result directly. What will come? Yes, it will be equal to 2 sin square h by. In denominator what will come? 1 minus cos 4h will be equal to 2 sin square 2h. Now here 2 and 2 will get cancelled there. We can write them separately. Okay. Limit h tends to 0. Sin h into sin h by. Denominator we have sin 2h into sin 2h. But to use the formula what we need here? Yes, we need h there. So here h multiplying both numerator and denominator by h. And here also in denominator we need 2h. So multiplying numerator and denominator by 2h. So this expression, all these expression will be equal to 1 there. Now remaining we are getting here h square by 2h into 2h will be equal to 4h square. Limit h tends to 0. So h square and h square will get cancelled. Our answer will be equal to 1 by 4. Okay. Now the next question. Next question is limit x tends to pi root 5 plus cos x minus 2 by pi minus x the whole square. Now just to check here this question. First one, it is an irrational number and inside the square root we have cos x. Means now we have to use two concepts here. One is we have to rationalize the numerator and after that we use the concept of limits of trigonometric function. So before using that, first what we can do, we can rationalize the numerator. Then we will get here into, what we will do? Yes, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by root 5 plus cos x plus 2 by root 5 plus cos x plus 2. Now, since we are rationalizing the numerator, we can use the identity a minus b into a plus b. So that will be equal to a square. So root 5 plus x cos x the whole square. So root and cos will get cancelled. Square root will get cancelled. We'll get there 5 plus cos x minus 2 square. So that will be equal to 4. By in denominator, what will come? Pi minus x the whole square into root 5 plus cos x plus 2. 5 minus 4 will be equal to 1. So now what we will do, in place of x, so now we will substitute pi plus h. So the question will become now limit h tends to 0, 5 minus 4 is 1 plus cos pi plus h by denominator will come pi minus h the whole square into square root of 5 plus cos pi plus h plus 2 equal to limit h tends to 0 cos pi plus something, which quadrant? Yes, third quadrant. And in third quadrant cos is negative. So we'll get there 1 minus cos h by here pi and pi will get cancelled. Minus h the whole square will be equal to h square into square root of 5. Again cos pi plus h is equal to minus cos h plus 2. Now again 1 minus cos h, how we can rewrite? Yes, that can be written as 2 sine square h by 2. So just write down there, this is equal to limit h tends to 0, 2 sine square h by 2 can be written as sine h by 2 into sine h by 2 by h square we have there. So we can write that h here so that it will be easy for us to use the formula there. Then the remaining in the denominator we have 5 minus cos h plus 2. Now just to check, to use the formula, here we have h by 2. So here also it should have h by 2. But we don't have here h by 2. Then what we should do? Yes, multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. Mean both. Okay. So now this expression will be equal to 1. In the same way, this one also will be equal to 1. Here 2 and 2 will get cancelled here. Now what is the remaining? Yes, the remaining expressions are limit h tends to 0, 1 by 2 into square root of 5 minus cos h plus 2. Now just to substitute, h is equal to 0. Then we will get 1 by 2 into 5 minus cos 0 is 1. So 5 minus 1, 4. square root of 4 is 2. So 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Then we will get the answer is equal to 1 by 8. Okay. Now, all these questions you can do when your concept of trigonometry is clear. Because you might have checked there. Whatever chapters we did there, in all the chapters we used the concept of trigonometry. So please learn all the formulas of trigonometry. Okay. Now, next question is, evaluate limit x tends to pi by 4 1 minus tan x by 1 minus root 2 sin x. Now here what we can do, in the whole expression root is not there, so we don't have to rationalize the denominator here. Okay, so directly what we can do, in place of x we can substitute pi by 4 plus h. So our expression will become now limit x tends to 0 1 minus tan pi by 4 plus h by, in denominator 1 minus root 2 into sin pi by 4 plus h. Now we can use the formula here, limit x tends to 0 1 minus tan a plus b. What is tan a plus b? Tan a plus tan b. So tan pi by 4 is 1 plus tan b. So that is tan h by 1 minus tan pi by 4 into tan h. So we'll get there 1 minus tan h by 1 minus root 2 into, here also we'll use the formula sin a plus b. Sin a plus b is sin a into cos b. So sin pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 into cos h plus cos pi by 4 1 by root 2 into sin h. Now here we'll do the cross multiplication, then we'll get limit h tends to 0 1 minus tan h minus 1 minus tan h by 1 minus tan h whole divided by root 2 will get multiplied inside, then we will get 1 minus root 2 and root 2 will get cancelled, here root 2 and root 2 will get cancelled, we will get there 1 minus cos h, here root 2 and root 2 will get cancelled, what will come here minus sin h. Okay, now here 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled. We will get there minus tan h will be equal to, yes, minus 2 tan h. So just write down there, limit x tends to 0 minus 2 tan h by, in denominator what is coming? 1 minus tan h into, here 1 minus cos h, how we can rewrite? Yes, that can be written as 2 sin square h by 2 minus sin h, how we can rewrite using the formula sin 2 theta? Yes, sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. So sin h can be written as 2 sin h by 2 into cos h by 2. Anything common is there? Yes, we have sin h by 2 common. So take it outside, limit h tends to 0 minus 2 tan h by 1 minus tan h into 2 sin h by 2 taken outside. Inside the bracket what will remain here? Sin h by 2 minus cos h by 2. Now just to check here, when we will substitute h is equal to 0, here 1 minus 0 will come. So we are not getting 0 here. But here, what will come? Here, if you will substitute, our denominator will become equal to 0. So here we have to use the formula. Sin h by 2 is there. Then what we can do here? Yes, we can multiply by h by 2, both numerator and denominator. Here no problem because it is in subtraction there. But here also, sin, if h by 2 is there, what we need there? Tan h is there. So tan h by h into h we need there. So this expression is equal to 1. this expression also will be equal to 1. Now here 2 and 2 will get cancelled, h and h also will get cancelled. Now in the remaining one we will substitute, h is equal to 0, then we will get 2 by 1 minus tan 0 is equal to 0. Then there what will come? Here it will be equal to, here minus sign is there, sin 0 minus cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, so we get there minus 1. So minus and minus will become plus. So our answer will be equal to 2. Okay. Now next question is limit x tends to a. Limit x tends to a sin root x minus sin root a by x minus a. So again first what we will do, we will rewrite x is equal to a plus h. So our expression will become now limit h tends to 0 sin root a plus h minus sin root a by a plus h minus a. So a and a will get cancelled here. Now in the numerator what we can do, we can use the formula sin c minus sin d. Sin c minus sin d is, yes, 2 cos c plus d by 2. So 2 cos square root of a plus h plus root a by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. So square root of a plus h minus root a by 2 divided by h equal to limit h tends to 0 2 cos root a plus h plus root a by 2 into sin root a plus h minus root a by 2 whole divided by h there. Now just check here. Here if you will substitute, h is equal to 0, no problem. It will not become equal to 0. But here, if you will substitute h is equal to 0, we will get it in the form of 0 by 0. So we know, we can use the formula. In place of theta, what we have? We have this expression. So we know sin theta by theta only equal to 1. So we need here square root of a plus h minus a by 2. So if I wrote it here in denominator, I have to multiply here in numerator also, then it will be equal to here square root of a plus h minus root a by 2 multiplied in both numerator and denominator. So this expression now will be equal to 1, and here this h we can shift there, then here also we can use the limit there, or if we want we can use at last only. Here I am using the limit, so this long expression we don't have to write there. So now what is the remaining expression we are getting? Limit h tends to 0 2 cos root a plus h plus root a by 2 into root a plus h minus root a by 2 and then divided by h. Now here just to check again, if we will substitute h is equal to 0, our numerator and denominator both will become equal to 0. So here what concept we can use? Yes, we can rationalize the numerator. So we will multiply it by square root of a plus h plus root a by square root of a plus h plus root a. Now we will simplify it, then we will get limit h tends to 0 2 into cos root a plus h plus root a by 2 into root a plus h minus, now here we can use the identity, it is written in the form of a minus b into a plus b, then we will get there a plus h minus a by 2 into root a plus h plus root a. Now here when we will change the division into multiplication, where this h will go? Yes, it will come in denominator. So it will come 1 by h there. So now just to check, a and minus a will get cancelled. This h and h also will get cancelled there. Now we can substitute h is equal to 0 in the remaining expression. So we will get there 2 cos root a plus root a. So that will be equal to 2 root a by 2. Here into h and h cancelled. In denominator we are getting 2 into. Again root a plus root a will be equal to 2 root a. Okay. So here 2 and 2 will get cancelled. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. So our answer will be equal to cos root a by 2 root a. Clear? Okay. Now we can do the next question. Next question is evaluate limit x tends to a cos x minus cos a by root x minus root a. So you can check here we have root there. So first what we can do, we can rationalize the denominator. So it will be equal to root x plus root a by root x plus root a. Then we will get limit x tends to a. Now here root x plus root a into root x minus root a, that will be equal to x minus a. Now here we are going to use the okay, so first we can write down there as it is cos x minus cos a into root x plus root a by x minus a. Now we can substitute x is equal to a plus h. X equal to a plus h. So our expression will become now limit h tends to 0 cos a plus h minus cos a into square root of a plus h plus root a by a plus h minus a. So a and minus a will get cancelled. Now remaining limit h tends to 0. Here we'll use the formula cos c minus cos d. That will be equal to minus 2 sin c plus d by 2. So a plus h plus a. So we'll get there 2a plus h by 2 into sin c minus d by 2, a plus h minus a by 2. So a and minus a will get cancelled. We'll get there h by 2 into root a plus h plus root a by h. But to use the formula here, because here only we'll give the form 0 by 0 when we will substitute h is equal to 0. So here if it is h by 2 there, here also we need h by 2 there. So this expression will be equal to now, this expression became 1. Now anything else will get cancelled? Yes, this 2 and 2 also will got cancelled there. Now in place of h we can substitute 0. So just to check what will come when we will substitute here 0. Minus 2, minus 2 got cancelled there. So minus sin 2a by 2. Minus sin 2a by 2 into this expression became 1. Here it will be equal to root a plus root a, which is equal to 2 root a. So here 2 and 2 also will get cancelled. So our answer will be equal to minus 2 root a into sin a. Clear? Okay. So I hope whatever questions we did today, these questions are clear to you. Already I gave you the homework through WhatsApp. So just do the question, and in case of any doubt you can ask. Thank you.